Hello, everyone. This is part 5 of the Cityville construction series. This again follows on from part 4. And when this finishes loading here, I'll actually remember what I was doing. Of course, I could watch the previous part and find out. But, okay, here we go. Here's the region. Since the last part, I've been opening and saving city tiles here. It will take a while to get all of them. There's quite a few in this region. It is huge. I've also added some highways and so on. Okay. And on to Cityville. Okay. I believe I just finished widening this out. So I think what I'll do is work more on filling in this area in the northeast corner here. See if I can get the population up a little higher so it will stay stably there. Let's see, what's demand for here? There's demand for high-tech industry. There's demand for all residentials. And what have we here? And real demand for, well, there's enough commercial demand. Okay. See, the land is fairly wavy here. It could get challenging building things here. Okay, what did I put here? Okay, that's commercial. Whoops. Extend this out a bit and bring this one down. I'll extend this out a bit. There we go. Well, that transition looks stupid. That looks just as stupid. Okay. Well, that's even dumber. Anyway, I'll leave that for now. Okay, I'll also bring this one down. Bring that one across. And that one. Okay. Now, what is this zoned as? High density, okay. So I'll continue with some high density zoning here for commercial. This is medium. Okay, I should make sure there's water here. Ah, yes. Water. High density does not like to develop without water. Well, it will develop, but it'll be the low density stuff that comes in. And we'll expand the commercial core here a little bit further. Now, that's annoying. Let's see if we can get that. There we go. There. Sometimes you need to do little tricks like that so you can zone something. The neat trick with zoning is you can get zones of any kind on any kind of a slope by zoning it and then using other techniques to terraform the land so that the land where that zone changes its slope. That won't destroy the zoning, which can be quite useful if you've ever seen any of those cities where people have those massive retaining walls between buildings, where there's a massive height difference. That's how they did it. They zoned the bottom out to the extent they wanted the zone, and then they raised it on the top, along the top, let the bottom fill in. Then they raised it along the top and let the top fill in. Or vice versa. And doing that, you get these type of retaining walls here, like these here. They can be any height in the game. So it will actually grow things that don't seem to make any sense just with the slope of the land. Now, it doesn't always work as expected. Sometimes what happens is the game will set the building for the lower level up at the height of the upper level or something equally bizarre. But on long straight stretches and so on, it does generally work. Okay, so that should give plenty of job prospects for the moment. Now it's time to fill in some residential. And I'll use the same 6-tile wide block space there up to here. And I'll fill those in with residential. First, though, I'll bring water in. Let's see. Let's just bring this all the way across and down. There we go. And now for the residential. I think I'm probably going to need a fire station here soon. Okay. I'll also put some here, but I'll make it four tiles deep. And I'll just make that. Well, this has to come out at least to here. Let's try that again. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Four and four. Okay. There are 4x4 buildings, so those will eventually fill in. Yeah, we have lots of headroom on the budget, so let's take a look here. Fire coverage. Yes, a fire station is going to be needed. Let's say about here. Sure, you can optimize the fire station coverage by, you know, minimizing the overlap in the coverage circles, but it's not worth the extra hassle to work out exactly how to do that. And that's always amusing when it says no road connection, when there's clearly a road there. I think it does that when the commute time gets too long. Although you would expect that to say no job or something like that. Okay, 2, 4, 6. I'll put another bigger road over here. And all the way up to the neighboring city. Bring these roads across. Yeah, like that. And like that. Here we've got 6 tiles. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do in here. Anyway, I'll bring the blocks all the way out here. And bring the road down here. Okay. This brings everything pretty much all the way out. And this I'll make residential. It makes sense. There's a hospital there. People want to live there. Okay. What's the distance here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Ah, I know what I can do here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. That fills it in nicely. Okay. More water placing here. Okay. Oh yes, across the top too. Good. Now, scrolling around tends to stall the simulation, so I'm going to leave it alone for a bit and speed things up. Okay, looks like hospital is, there we go, that one's underfunded. So if we boost the funding, yeah, we'll leave it there. That should be good for quite a while. You can see one of the problems with starting from the bottom up and needing the city to develop naturally, so to speak, is often you have to wait for things to happen before you start doing more stuff. You can't just go running around willy-nilly, plopping things down all over the place and putting zones without actually thinking about what they will actually do. And if you have too much of them laying around, not being used, it can be problematic. It's not that it prevents development, but it just looks terrible, and it takes time, and you can set it all up, but it's not going to fill in any faster, really, than what we're seeing going on here. As you can see, some medium-rise buildings have come in. There's a couple of high-rises. Apparently, the Sims want a stadium. The monthly cost is reasonable. I see we got some abandonment issues coming up here. I wonder if that's partly due to. Actually, that's commercial stuff there. Probably lack of demand or jobs. Anyway, let's see. Let's put the simulation back to a sane speed here. Let's build a stadium. Now, put the stadium down here where there's a major intersection. Now that, I think that's close enough to the fire station that the power gets to it. The stadium raises some demand caps, which can help with things. Recreation also helps in general for the Sims. Let's see. Yeah, imagine the air pollution is bothering the Sims a bit too. We're not pumping water out of the polluted area, so it's probably not that big of a problem. Let's look here. Notice that we've got a pretty good mayor rating. That's actually helpful for keeping your city running. It means the Sims are reasonably happy. So it's actually good to keep it up there. Oh, that's cute. Lawyer sues to get empty spaces filled. Hates holes and gaps. Okay. Oh, no, power's getting there. Okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put up some commercial right around the stadium. And voila, power. Now. Oh yes, I put the pipes already. Let's see. Oh yes, I'll probably want police coverage here. Yes, I believe that's going to be important. That might be part of why things aren't filling in as much. I'll put the police over here. And I think it might be good to have some police over here. Yeah, I think that would be good. And maybe a police station over here. Cute. Aging's sure sign of getting old, says science researcher. Okay, let's see. Some of the headlines are kind of amusing, even if you've seen them a few hundred dozen times. Okay, let's fill this in. Let's speed it up again and see what happens. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to build a little industrial subdivision over here. I'm going to bend the avenue here. Yes, right. We established before we can't go diagonally. And okay. Now, I don't want the U-turn problem there, so you can make a nice U-turn spot by dragging a street through the avenue. Oh, bugger. I didn't line that up properly. Okay, let's line that up properly. There we go. There you go. See, it's a little straighter now. Okay. Now, unlike others, I'm not so concerned about the bumpiness here. It's not really that bumpy. I've seen plenty of actual streets that go up and down like that. Now, let's see. I'll bring a water main across there. Over like so, and like so, and just because of my CDO there, I'll bring the pipe to the edge of the map. Oh, in case you're wondering, CDO is the same as OCD, except it's in alphabetical order. And I do not take credit for that one. I heard it from somebody else. Okay, so in here we need some. Oh, right, yes. Right, I'm going to have to use a road to do that. Right. Yeah, I might as well just stick with a road. Make a neighbor connection there. And building the streets for this industrial development that I'm putting in here. Okay, I need another street here, a road here. Let's make this a roundabout. And we'll go off this way. And make a connection like so. And we'll go off this way. And have a road come across straight like that. And what here? No. There we go. That's the same as a regular 90 corner. It's just slightly smoother. That's from the NAM. It looks nice. Nicer.
You notice you can only drag it in one direction. The other direction, you get that weird angled thing going on. But it takes the same tile space as the regular sharp 90. That happens by default. Right, you can't do that. Okay. That is not what I wanted. Nope. That's what I want. I wanted a nice 45 there. Actually, I'll bring this road up the side and make a connection there. And I'll bring this one over, and again, a roundabout. There we go. Oh, that's just dumb. I've seen roundabouts like that in the wild. They're just dumb. Clearly need to go this way. Yes, that's better. Okay, and I'll go up like so. And bring this one out this way. Bring this one out this way. And here I'll use the sharp 90. I think. Yes, that's fine. If you're wondering, that click there gives you a wide radius smooth curve. I'm basically putting a road tile inside the 45 degree bend. It's another NAM thing. It's quite nice. You know, it will fill in with a sidewalk when the area develops. And over this way, I'll go over here and we'll do it like so. There we go. I'll call that a road network for the area. Why all the weird road layout? Well, we'll just pretend that there was a city character, planner, that had some idiocy going on. I see we have a fire, so I better dispatch the fire department here. And they're nice and close in this case. This must be just outside the reach. Why is it a fire? Ah, yeah, it is just on the edge. That would do it. Okay. Now, I've got the go-to disasters thing turned off because I've had too many cases where a disaster firing would plop down a road the whole length of a map and destroy half the city. I just noticed that the game paused suddenly, so that told me that there had to be a disaster. Now, it looks like a power plant is getting old. Yeah, the old coal plant over here. Okay, let's see what we can replace. Oh, we got the solar plants back. So, we'll just put one of them over here and go remove this old coal plant here. That should improve the air a bit as well. Okay. Now, this is a another mayor statue. Yeah, let's find somewhere to put this. How about over here? There we go. Now, slow things down to a sane pace again. Let's see. Oh yes, I need to put water in here. Into the rest of this. So that means, because again, I have this obsession with following the road network with the pipes. I will do that here. As I mentioned in a previous part, there's no requirement to follow the roads, but it's just my thing. If you want to build your city with pipes going willy-nilly all over, that's perfectly fine. It's your city. Now let's clean up some of this nonsense here. Okay, I'll just leave that. Anyway, that's pipes in there. So let's zone it. Okay. There's an industrial area. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to put a sort of park area around the stadium here. That will probably help with the building trees complaints. Okay, so over in here, I'll use these forest parks here, and let's go for pines over here. Actually, I'll use the 2x2 versions here. It'll go a lot faster. Every city needs some green spaces like this in the city. Actually, I'll stop there. I'll put some commercial or residential here. Now that we've got power over there, that's going to start filling in. Okay. Now, where is it? There it is. Okay, let's get it so I can see what I'm doing here. I'll go all the way up here. Make this whole area a massive park. This should also increase land values in the area. I can fill the rest of this in with the one tile version. Here we go. Okay, and I'll fill in the little bits over here as well. Oh, I got a bit there to fill in. I need to bring this down a little further as well. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Come down to here. Okay, now some more 2x2 ones. And for some reason, I'm just reminded of this bit from the old Firefly TV series. Whoever they were coming after River Tam, you know, the whole 2x2 hands of blue thing. Talk about random, eh? Let's see. Totally not related at all. Okay. You'll note that this seems to have developed in a little bit as a result of this. Alright, I was going to put something here. I'll make it residential. There we go. The residential type should love having a forest in back of them. Now here, I am going to run a pipe through the middle of nothing. And that's just so that the forest has irrigation here. That makes it less flammable to do that. So if fire coverage is a bit thin, it's less likely the forest will actually go up in smoke. Oh, I missed a spot there. There we go. There, now we have a nice little patch of forest in the middle of the city. That sort of thing, I've seen it in quite a few places, separating residential from industrial development and that sort of thing. What I'm probably going to do is run the green space all the way up to the city boundary here and probably bring it down, possibly around toward the other boundary over here. You could call it even a sort of wildlife corridor. If you remember, there's mountains in the next tile just north of here. So it would make sense to have some sort of wildlife corridor through the city. Let's see about demand here. This stuff has been holding pretty constant. I sped up the simulation again so that things can develop a bit more. I would expect the high wealth residential demand to increase a bit as a result of the added park space. And the forest parks do count as parks. There is, of course, a maintenance cost associated with them. But here we go. The demand climbed. And now it just spawned a bunch of stuff, so it dropped a bit. Huh, that's interesting. It looks like there's a sort of pergola thing over the parking lot at the hospital. anyway, let's see. As you can see, there's a fair slope on the land, so we're getting these retaining walls here. The industrial is filled in nice here. Let's take a look at the pollution map. Air pollution. There's a little bit over here. This pollution here along the roads is basically, I think the theory is it's road noise. And here's pollution from the actual industry. And here we got the parks here, which I built these before I had the forest parks installed. So that's just trees, right? Then we got the massive air pollution over here from the dirty industry. Oh my, it looks like the landfill is getting on edge here. Might be time to expand that. Let's see. You may think that the landfill will get ever bigger. You know, always have to have more and more space. It actually doesn't work that way. This will actually, if you reduce the amount of garbage going in, this will actually empty out. Let's see. Right, I was going to make a Another landfill. Okay, I made that one 8. Okay. And put it here. I think it'd be a good idea to save the game here. There we go. Right. Now let's look at water pollution. We have some substantial water pollution here. Obviously, we've got the agricultural pollution. And then there's the pollution from the industry over here. But notice there isn't really any pollution in the water over here. There is some over here from the city, but there isn't over here. And that's mostly due to the high-tech industry being generally fairly clean. Okay, let's look at land value just for giggles. And now, the green is higher desirability, higher value. The red is the low value. You can see we've got a fairly high value around here. It's lower further from the park. Other things like hospitals and schools will affect that as well. And pollution, things like that. You can see it gets really less desirable here where the extent of the air pollution is. Okay. Now we're up to 40,000 Sims for the population, so that's getting that's actually getting to be quite good. What have we got here? The religious... we got another church being requested. Let's just build that, shall we? I'll put it over here. City courting new grounds. That's a courthouse. Yeah, a courthouse is a good idea to have. I'll put that over here by the commercial stuff here. There we go. Now, something we can do for the education level and so on is also build libraries, and that's what they're asking for here. And I'll probably do that. Okay. Yeah, let's do that. Let's put some libraries. Now, that's under education. Now, the Goobergen Library is a nice one. Let's just put that in here. Now, it wants a corner placement. It's 4x4. Well, it's 4x4, so we've got that area over by the hospital here. This would make a perfect spot for it. And, of course, it goes the wrong way. Get it back. I think. No. I need to make sure it points at a road. I need to pay attention to those arrows. Yeah, that's what I want, right that way. There we go. Looks like it's missing a texture under here. Let's level this spot. That might be why it's having an issue, is due to that. There we go. Give it a level lot in there. Actually, if I'm going to do that, I might as well level this too. See how fast this population number has been going up since I put those parks in. And the library here has made a big difference as well. Okay, I'm going to bring a road through here. Okay, and I'm going to extend the green space just like I was talking about. Slow the simulation back down. I'll bring it all the way to the city border. Kind of makes sense. There's that little valley thing here. Okay, now I need to fill in here. Okay. And also now the industrial people over here have more roads in. I'll bring this up to the boundary. And this one. Bring this one off at an angle. Now that's not going to work. Now bring this one across here. Bring one across here. One across like this. Yeah, we'll do that. Bring this road up the side. And Like so. And also need to get water through here. Okay, I can make this a little more to my liking this way. And I bring this down, this over, and this over. Okay, now I got water there. I don't need this one going across here now. Okay. Now, I'll zone the rest of this industrial. High density again, so that the high-tech stuff will grow. Now, the industry stuff actually likes the being close to the city boundary because the freight can get to the edge quickly. The neighbor connections themselves also help with other aspects of things. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put some green space over here. I'll just use a regular grass area here. Okay, so that should sort that out. Now, I expect the population is probably going to stagnate again soon, and require some more coercing into growing. The last city I worked with, I had the Colossus add-on mod installed, and that has a feature where unless you do something really fiddly with it, it ends up pretty much doubling the demand for commercial and I think industrial, and that makes it a lot easier to grow a city because you can just stack up on commercial and you don't end up with a huge abandonment issue. Still, that does, it also means that you get these much taller buildings and higher level growth stages, which, it's neat, but you end up with stuff that's so dense you can't see anything when you're trying to deal with your city. I think last time I was talking about bringing a rail line across here. I think I'll do that. I think I'll bring a heavy rail line across. So what I'll do is I'll put the simulation back at a sane speed and I'll build the rail line. Okay, that'd be under rail, surprisingly enough. And where's the... There it is. And I think I'll bring it across. Which side of the highway will I bring it across on? I think I'll bring it across on the south side of the highway. And I'll bring it around through this little hamlet over here. So it'll come in over here. And then it will come along here and we'll angle down toward the hamlet. And it'll come across over here. As it so often does in small towns, right beside a street. Okay, and I'll have it come up along this way. And there you have the reason for the fancy road layout over here now. Okay. Oops. Okay. So there we have a rail line across. I suppose it'd be reasonable to suppose there'd be one that came up this way, but I'll leave it like that for now. What I'm going to do, though, is... Okay, we'll make it a wider curve. Right. And I do that, and it takes the curve out. Right. Okay. There we go there. And here we go there. Over here, I'm not sure we can fit one in, but I'll try it. If I can't, it's not a big deal because the train would theoretically be running slower through the town anyway. But it does fit. How about that? And it's, oh, come on. Okay, and one more. There we go. That actually looks quite a bit better. Okay. So, there is a rail here. I see there isn't a texture for the road crossing here. Anyway. So far, so good. Well, I know what I'll do. I'll bring a rail line up here. And that requires a station. Where is the train station? That's a passenger station. Freight station. Right, now I need to finish building the rail line, which, see, that's the problem when you've got, here, I'll fix that. Okay, now, rail again, right. There we go. Now, we can't do a rail crossing over the, or like a at-grade crossing on the highway. So I'm going to have to, and because of the proximity here, I'm going to have to go under, I think. Yes, I think I'm going to have to go under. What I need is level ground here a little bit. Okay, that's got me some level ground. What I need is a hole digger. Those are in here. Digger. Let's see if 15 meters is enough. Start the tunnel. I'm too close to the water. Okay. I'll have to go over. Okay. I still want the level ground for that. But I'll need more level ground. Because I need a transition. Okay. Now, what have I got here? Rail viaducts. Okay. Ah. 8S. I need to go over an 8S. Wrong way around. And I need to go over the 8S here. Okay. And rail puzzle pieces. Straight. I need a straight piece here. Right. And are there any on slope transitions? There is one. Okay. How high is that? What I need is a razor. Let's try 15 meters. Okay, and diagonal on slope, straight on slope. That's it. That's the one I need. Okay, and if I stay up here, can I get, okay, I think I know how I'm going to do that. Okay, now. Go. Now, there we go. That's one side of it. Let's save that. Okay, now I need to demolish this. I need to bring this out a little ways so that I can have my transition. Okay. Rail puzzle pieces. Okay, I need to come down. And where does this come? Okay, that's not quite gonna line up where I want it, is it? What I need is a switch thingy. That's not exactly what I want there. I think I need that to Y split. Y splitter. Yeah, that's what I want there, is a Y splitter. Then I need that 45 degree Dewey. Regular switch thingy here. Yes, that's what I need. Now, I need to link these up. Okay. Now. Curves. I need a 45. And I need to bring this up. And I need another 45. Whoops. And that is there. Okay. Link it up. And this, obviously, I need to shift over. Oh, yes. Clean that up too. Bring this down. And one more curve. There we go. Okay. I now have a line going up here. What I'm going to do is bring this all the way to the boundary. Okay. That, I believe, sorts that out. Now, since we already have a rail station there, let's put a passenger station here too. And a passenger station way over here. For these people. Where? I think that should work. Let's get things going here. Odds are nobody's going to use it. Oh, some are. I'm not expecting freight usage due to the proximity of this neighbor connection over here. Okay. Okay, I'll save the game here. The population is approaching 50,000 Sims. But with that, the rail line and this development and green space up here, I'm going to call it apart. And I'll see everybody next time. Just before I go, let's take a look at the transportation view. Okay, you can see the rail lines here, and probably at some point I'll link these up with something. Probably I'll bring this line this way and this one this way. And continue following the main highway this way. Though I'm not entirely certain how that's going to set up in the rest of the region. Like the main rail line will probably come down and follow this pass here, and the other one will follow this path over here. Actually, it'll probably come through this pass. Anyway, as I said, I'm calling it a part, so I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching.